Welcome. Before we begin today's program, I want to make one thing very clear. I have never played a game of Dungeons & Dragons, so everything that I'm about to say in this video comes from a place of casual outsider's perception of this legendary game, which I rolled for, of course. Over the course of today's video, I'm probably going to say something that's silly, or wrong, or misrepresents how this game is actually played. Well, too bad. It's science time. ARIA, activate the DM screen. Oh, hello there, traveler. I know you're on a big grand adventure and all, but as a elf scientist? I guess that's what I'm going for? As an elf scientist trapped in your confusingly grid-based world, I have a query. That bag there at your side. Ever wonder how it works? Because I have science that says otherwise. Ho ho! Adventure!
Your party has stumbled upon the facility. Now inside, your party encounters the administrator.
Why, hello there, traveler. Your magical bag there, it's quite curious. May I take a look? Dexterity check. Ha ha! Yoink. According to the legend of the mass-produced game manual, this is a bag of holding, with the dimensions 2 feet wide in diameter at the mouth and 4 feet deep, allowing for exactly 64 cubic feet or 1.8 cubic meters of put stuff in its space, and then forget about it until you're reminded by your DM a couple weeks later. It's also, according to legend, that a breathing creature can only spend 10 minutes inside of the bag before they, well, expire. What an interesting line to include in legend. It probably makes for some interesting decision making, but is it true? Well, follow me.
Your party encounters an absolutely gorgeous talking rectangle.
Traveler, you appear humanoid to me, or maybe even human, so we are going to consider humans as our breathing creatures to analyze this most famous of bags. Now, human breathing, or respiration, is relatively simple, at least compared to other organisms like insects or birds. Now, when you breathe, you increase the size of your lungs, you increase the volume of the lungs with the help of powerful muscles. This creates a section of low-pressure air inside of your breathing sacky sacs, or lungs, I guess. Now, once this is at a lower pressure, it's at a lower pressure relative to the rest of the atmosphere. And so the atmosphere follows a pressure gradient into your lungs. The atmosphere is what is forcing you to breathe, more or less. Now, once you have that air inside of your lungs, it fills all the tiny sacky sacky sac breathing sacs, and these sacs are very, very close to your actual blood in your bloodstream. Now the air can follow a concentration gradient into the bloodstream and oxygenates your whole body as it travels around with the help of hemoglobin and stuff, and it continues the thing that you call life, I guess. That is, unless you're a greater necromancer, because then we all know what that means. We all know what that means, especially me. Perception check. Nice try, Kevin. You should have specced into mage, dum-dum. Now it's time for some math, something that board game players know almost nothing about. So if we have our bag of holding with 1.8 cubic meters at maximum of air, 21% of that air will be oxygen if it's a normal Earth-like atmosphere. And if I consult my Tome of Studies for humans, you find that 250 milliliters of oxygen per minute is the intake rate for these hairless apes. Now, if we convert our units carefully and we solve this very simple equation, you find that the O2 in a normal bag of holding will last for 1,500 minutes. That's over 24 hours. That's a lot longer than the 10 minutes we spent hiding in a bag of holding from the Goblin King of Red Hollow, isn't it, adventurers? Don't act like you don't remember that little escapade. That was canon.
The administrator climbs aboard his hyperrail, increasing speed plus 20.
Now, if that math seemed a bit too simplistic for you, traveler, that's because it totally was. Of course, humans don't just intake oxygen, they also expel carbon dioxide, which is a byproduct of human respiration. So if they're in an enclosed space, a human will be increasing the concentration of carbon dioxide in that bag over time, and that could, in theory, bring the survival time inside a bag of holding way down. But did the legendary wizards of the coast do their homework? Is that all the way down to 10 minutes? Ho-ho! We'll find out. Breathing oxygen wasn't always part of life's plan. In fact, when life began, oxygen wasn't really involved with life. Well, it was detrimental to it. You see, 2.4 billion years ago, single-celled organisms called cyanobacteria were happily photosynthesizing away in Earth's early oceans. As they did so, they were producing oxygen as a byproduct, like we do with carbon dioxide. Life at this point in the early oceans hadn't figured out how to really utilize efficiently this highly reactive and basically poisonous element. So over the next 400 million years, the Earth's atmosphere started to accumulate great amounts of oxygen in the atmosphere, and what is called the Great Oxidation Event forced as a kind of evolutionary pressure the evolution of multicellular life, like you and me. So take a deep breath and thank some little cyano boys for it.
Your party encounters definitely not a supervillain, and Lola, who has, like, so much HP, don't even think about it.
Welcome back, Traveler. If you're breathing in an enclosed space over time, what's in that air is going to change. More specifically, as you breathe, the oxygen levels in that space will go down and the carbon dioxide levels will go up, like the amount of body odor at your local game store on game night. And once the fraction of carbon dioxide in the air that you're breathing gets just a little bit above the tiny fraction it usually is, bad stuff starts happening to the human body. For example, at just 0.1%, things feel off and you're getting a slight headache. At 1%, your breathing rate is increasing and you're having trouble concentrating. If you triple that rate to 3%, things start to get pretty dang bad. You are doubling your breathing rate and you're dizzy and you're panting. At and above 5% carbon dioxide concentration in the air that you're breathing and prolonged exposure will lead to death. So if we are to science the magical bag of holding as we're wont to do, then I say we leave 3% carbon dioxide in the bag as the target that we do not want to meet. So now let's return to the math. I cast display equation. Come on, do it. I don't want to roll for it. Again, we have 64 cubic feet to work with. If you were stored or hiding in it, when will the air inside a bag of holding get to 3% carbon dioxide? Well, if I read another inscription in my tome of studies, humans expel about a third of a liter of carbon dioxide every minute. So now our equation looks like this for a moderately stressed human, where V is the volume of the space, P is the dangerous percentage of CO2 you do not want to hit, E is the expel rate of CO2 per minute, and N is how many humans are in said volume. If we then plug in the numbers for one human inside a canonical bag of holding, we get a survival time of 145 minutes. 145 minutes, Traveler, is almost 2.5 hours. So scientifically, we can say then that those legendary wizards who reside on the coast have seriously underestimated the true survival time inside of a bag of holding. What were they trying to do? Design a game that's playable in real time? And if the bag was only to allow 10 minutes of breathing time, according to the science, it should be much, much smaller. Just 4.5 cubic feet. That's 14 times smaller than is stated in the legends. An item that small wouldn't even be able to hold a frost troll's attention span. And we are all very aware of how small that is. We are all very aware of that fact. Ha ha! Adventure.
Your party senses that the administrator is approaching a conclusion.
Of course, I know what you may be thinking right now, Traveler. Bag of Holding lore only says breathing creatures, not breathing humans specifically, and there are a lot of creatures that breathe around here in the land with the grid on it. So yes, it is true that if you were to try to stuff a classic D&D monster like the reverse centaur into a bag of holding, yes, look at it, then it might, being as majestic as it is, expel a lot more carbon dioxide every minute, bringing survival times way down. Would it be 10 minutes? I don't know. I would have to study this beautiful beast. And think about stuffing a warrior squirrel, classic, inside of a bag of holding. And just, you know, it's running around in there with its tiny little sword and like an acorn top shield. Anyway, that might expel a lot less carbon dioxide than a human, and so it would last a lot longer. It's complicated. But our adventure is nearing its end, so I think we should conclude thusly. One sec. Scientifically speaking, the bag of holding can indeed hold and harbor living, breathing creatures. But any intrepid traveler who wants to know for exactly how long must use this ye olde equation that this little elf scientist has come up with, and not the stated 10-minute value. Doing so, adding a little bit of science to your magic, will just add that much more intelligence to your adventures and afford you a lot more opportunities when you're questing through the Duke of Barbaria's lands. He's definitely not a guy and a place I just made up. Good luck, traveler. And grab some graph paper on the way out. I think you can use it. Until next time.
Now exiting the facility.
Thank you so much to the very nerdy staff at the facility for their direct and substantial support in the creation of Ye Olde Video. Today especially, I want to recognize research assistant Rudy Crabb and visiting scholar Flailing Tools. Oh, my hammers! If you want to get on the facility staff, if you want to join us, over 1,200 of us who every day are getting behind the scenes content, talking with me on Discord, giving me episode ideas, having a Magic the Gathering League, all related wizard. There's even a D&D group. You can go to patreon.com/KyleHill and sign up today. And if you support the facility just enough, you get your name on ARIA here each and every week. And as you can see, there's over 1,000 of you. So there's no way I can pass all the... Wizards of the Coast, if you're watching this, we've worked together professionally before. You have my email. I'm not saying that the next edition of the Dungeons & Dragons book has to include some kind of calculation for the bag of holding going forward. I'm just saying... Board game nerds love math. D&D has a lot of numbers. And then you could just put a picture of some weird looking elf scientist in it. And it's a win, 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 win. So many wins. Thanks for watching. What is a kobold quickblade? Really?